Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Throwback Thursday. I'm trying to look for what to throw back. None for now. Other than that, before I delve into any of the day's gossip, it's quite simple. Nana Habo Mouthwash, that's a proud sponsor of the show, and I am definitely begging you and asking you to indulge your senses a little bit, especially your mouth senses, and you know, get the product. It works. Telling you, I have. Okay, I can't be able to get into that because I'm not allowed to say it on national television. But it's a good situation you need to get yourself up on. My name is Tina Fierce One. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Still on that concert-ish that we talked about yesterday. I told you about the people who have upcoming concerts. Kakati, we caught up with Graviton Mtuju about his Embuzi Ziku today. And we had a couple of questions. You know, there were so many allegations. The last concert that he held, yes, Yagena Mchukubo, apparently, Mbu Ntino, Yagena Mchukubo Nasoka Nagaba Ticket, Ezo Werede, Nakwata Tipa. Nazi parking abantu abantu yabajawabe yaleta ya mutipa. Tetumanyi na yeye inaje ya basonda. Entebero diyo na yaji collecting ane muja ne muju ze chifo. So we asked him about all that stuff. And he goes like, no, I've never done nothing like that. It's the sponsors. Are those the same sponsors that have come on board now? Man, that is throwing your sponsor under the bus. But you have to understand, the sponsor also has to give away. So is he trying to say that the sponsor gave away about close to 1,000 tickets, half of cricket over? I wouldn't get into bed with those sponsors again, but he clearly has.
Hello, yellow. My name is Graviton Mtuju Mukujukuju Muganda Wachi Wetere Mukwano Gwakoni. I'm here to tell you that, or to call you, or to come and support me on 22nd September at Cricket Oval, as we did it last year. Let us do it again, straight up. This year we have a play with Ebony. It's called Embuzi Zako Today. So expect to enjoy with Ebony and other guys.
Yeah. I think today is the day for the underdogs. Today is for all those failing artists that we're still trying to, well, prove a point to that you can't make it in this industry. So today is their gossip day. So Big I just posted something. He was on a flight, you know. And he was not on a regular flight, apparently. That is what my peeps around me are saying. I'm like, wait, did he take like a private jet or something? They're like, no, yo, he's flying first class. Do you know what that means? For a guy who can barely construct three words in English and has a failed career, it's a beautiful thing. I was like, wait. I mean, aliku podium. I think Brian White can spare a few dollars here and there for him to fly like that. But the question though, again, the quality convention. Kwa gamba wali yo promoter. Atula, muyafisi ye nagamba. Who do the people in the UK from Uganda want from here? And then they go like, I think tuagala Big Eye. I mean, what songs is Big Eye going to sing? Mango Juicy. And the other one, I didn't know. Olimbo lala uli uli ina mani agata tegerekeka. What is it called? Something. Salumbas? Biagendo yimba. Meanwhile, is it back with Donzella? Just in case this money is not coming from the podium. Do you think Donzella is definitely financing? I mean, he a baby dada. You know? So, nowadays baby dadas are asking to cut for them checks. So, I'm not so sure. But the reason we're having this conversation is the fact that he actually took a first class ticket flight to London. What he's going to do there, it's absurd, but he's going to do it, so yay! That's the story, right? Wow! So yesterday, the church service that was held at Bubaga, wow! It all started out so nice! It was so nice! Until at the end, there was stuff going on, but first of all, I would like to commend Lil Puzzle on remembering when to make the perfect comeback. Because yes, he made his comeback, but in my head I was like, wait! Gendo Gule Motoka ya Genda. Did he release another song after Gendo Gule Motoka? Huh? Mutegede mutienze. When it took me a while, I kept watching. I'm like, where have I seen that face? Where? Then I remember there was an artist called Lil Puzzle. Gendo Gule Motoka, the guy who we thought was going to replace Fik Famaker. No, that was before Fik. You know, we thought he was going to be our fix for maker. We thought he was going to be our new gravity. We thought he was going to be our new young mulo. Go saga ne industry na balongo jebali. Sitani aline fujo. He was there. Chameleon did the same. Chameleon was just being Chameleon, you know? Came in with a gang of people all walking and, you know, strides and everything. Then the part where there was time, it was time for Holy Communion, right? I've never seen church lituated like that. Woo, child! I bet you Jesus was seated there like, because it was so weird how they were all lining up. And then when they would get the Holy Communion and then you'd be like, that's probably the first time in the past 15 years since he actually turned up for church. But it was nice still. It was nice. For the first time, I actually saw something happen and it was a little bit more peaceful than usual. They were all over, you know, emotions were high and everything, but there was the peace. There was a certain level of peace. I was like, yeah, I'll have that. But did anyone see, which of our female artists were there? Because it, Mwabalabi, Shibayabadeo, Juliana. It takes a lot to make a grown man cry. It does, it does. And I saw him shed those tears and I was like, you know what? I felt sympathy. I really did. I really did. And the first thing he asked for is like, where's my wife? At that moment, it changed my entire outlook on life. I was like, I need to get me a man. Who through thick and thin, the first thing they're thinking about is, where's my wife? I need to get me one. I need to get me one. But I only want to get me a man who is going to be like Bobby, if he can actually be like Bobby, the way Bobby is with Bobby. How possible is that? Oh, well, it's been a really, really, really interesting week. That's all I can say. It's been a really interesting week. And of course, there's still more stuff going to be coming out. All of us are glued to the television, you know? We're glued to the radio sets. We're glued to anything that gives us, you know, inside feedback because we're trying to figure it out. We're trying to figure it out. But today, I watched that man walk out of court and I was like, you know what, Bobby? You know what? You got my sympathy card now. And given it's a Thursday, let me try to throw it back. Now I know, but I haven't gone to Twitter video. I have two things I want to throw it back, but to throw back to. First thing I'm going to throw back to, y'all remember when Dennis Onyango, the goalkeeper, was the East? Wow, child! When he won that goalkeeper of the year for, was it for Africa? Uganda, I saw Slave Queens losing their ish, and then their hearts would break immediately when they would tell them he's a married guy, has kids. I was like, God, I have personal friends who are looking for David, for that guy. They were looking for him, or they were looking for him. I personally waited for him here because I don't understand it. I think about soccer, but I wanted to know who is this guy they are singing praises for, and then I met him. I really didn't see the va-va-voom qualities, but he has some big hands. Anyway, that's been my time. I'll catch you tomorrow when it's all Friday. Oh, I can't wait for tomorrow because I'm going to rest this weekend. I feel like I need to do something out of the pocket. If I ask you one thing that I could do this weekend out of the pocket, what would you tell me to do? So out of the pocket, so random. Learn how to swim. Are you crazy? It's like telling me to take an elevator. Two things you don't put me in an elevator or tell me to swim. Anyway, @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and @TinaFierce1. Like and follow the pages. On Instagram it's @TinaFierce1 with an 8. I'm out. Catch you tomorrow. Peace.
Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Habbo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.